parties. Well, most of you know where this video was shot and what time. Yes, I am with the XBHP team riding the Dominar 2019 model, and we were riding in Bhutan in amazing and challenging conditions, and now we've entered India into West Bengal, and we are at a beautiful tea estate. And now, what am I doing here? I'm going to be doing a review of the Dominar 2019, which most of you asked me that Vikas, most of the other YouTubers have reviewed this machine, why haven't you? Because the reason is that I was looking to take her out, ride her in proper, serious conditions, and then talk about how this machine feels like. Because as you know, the previous version, the first generation of the Dominar, I took it to Ladakh, rode her extensively, and I was very happy. And most of you shared the same feeling that I did, and many of you even bought the Dominar first generation. But you know what? Having said this, when the 2019 model was launched, I was not very happy. Yes, there are a few reasons why. One, I'm not a fan of upside down forks in Indian conditions, you know, because you know this, I spoke about oil seals in a very technical manner many times, and when buddy, could you get a little closer please? And generally in upside down forks, what happens is that sand, mud and all of that touches the tube part of the shock, and this can get into the oil seal and it can bust the oil seal. And when you are on a long tour, you definitely don't want that to happen. So I was very apprehensive about this part. All right. Next thing, what I was not happy about the 2019 Dominar is the exhaust. I had a look at it and I thought, what is this? Why is it so big? I didn't like it so much in the first impression. You know, in life people say that first impression is the best impression, but trust me, it can change. And the next thing, when I got to know that in this great odyssey that XBHP and Dominar is doing, I would be riding the Dominar 2019 in Bhutan, in the mountains, in crazy conditions, I thought this is a good time to test her out. So I'll go point by point of what I actually liked. Number one, see, Dominar is a machine which, as I said, always is a very versatile machine, which can be used for daily commute, which can be used for touring, okay? And for touring, the most important thing is that the machine cannot feel small, okay? Because you would be riding for 10 hours, 12 hours a day when you are touring, and you want the seat to be wide. You want the machine to feel like kind of a big machine. I understand she's a 373cc, not a 600 or an 800, but when you sit on this machine, you feel like you are actually riding a 600 plus cc motorcycle. I've said this about the previous version also. And yes, this is the fourth day that I'm riding this machine and loved it. We've been on the seat for well over 10 hours, okay? And the seat here, although we have an aftermarket seat here, but even without this, this seat is good enough, because I know this because I took this machine to Ladakh and I absolutely had no problem. And the thing that I was most apprehensive about, that is your fork oil seals leaking during touring, did not happen. And if it did not happen, in our conditions where we were riding in Bhutan, I am almost sure that these oil seals are doing a great job, and I'm kind of convinced with the change that Bajaj did, where they moved from conventional to upside down forks. And next thing which I really liked is when we were riding yesterday in the mountains of Bhutan, there were patches where the road was extremely bad and the fog was so much, the cloud was so dense that I almost went into some really bad potholes. And you know, when we have alloy wheels, okay, alloy wheels and potholes are not really friends. You've seen what happened to me on my other motorcycles. These things can bend and they can crack, but it did not happen with any of our three motorcycles. So good thing, well done. You know, they look stylish, but very, very good alloy wheels. And next, as I mentioned about the fog, about the cloud cover, check this clip out.
Oh my God, buddy, is kuch bhi nahi dikh raha yaar yahan pe. We are riding in between clouds and visibility shayad 10 feet bhi nahi hoga. Oh wow, I mean, adventurous hai, khoobsurat hai, but very, very dangerous.
So you saw how dense the fog was, right? I mean, it was almost zero visibility. And I gotta say this, that the headlight of the Dominar, the stock headlight, although we have aftermarket ones, we were not using these. The stock headlight is so good that it was an absolute life saver for me and for other riders. This was illuminating the road very, very well. And well, we could almost kind of see through the fog and go ahead. I would almost go to the level of saying that this is probably the best stock headlight that any Indian motorcycle, or for that matter, even many other, you know, imported motorcycles can offer. Now let's talk about this suspension, because number one, when you'd be touring, you'll be having a lot of luggage like we do. Okay, you see all this? This is solid metal. Okay, all of this, we probably added about 100 kilograms of weight onto this. Okay, motorcycle, this motorcycle is already about 180 kgs, 100 more, so that's 280 kgs. I'm about 75 kgs. With all the gear, I'm probably 100 kgs, so you are talking about close to 400 kgs of weight. Okay, and if the suspension is not good, you'll not be able to ride a motorcycle like this, because the suspension will bottom out or it will rebound very badly. And when you're touring, you don't want very stiff suspension, neither do you want very soft suspension, because soft suspension will bottom out and very stiff suspension will give you body aches. So this suspension is actually striking a balance between both of them and felt very, very comfortable there. And I had mentioned that I did not like the way this exhaust looks. Okay, I indeed did not like it the way it looks. And on videos which other YouTubers posted, they probably didn't record it with a good mic, and I didn't like the sound either in the first impression. But when I'm riding this motorcycle, when I'm actually revving her up, trust me, people are turning back and looking at us. She sounds really, really good with the stock exhaust. So well, although I didn't like the way she looks, but the sound, cheers, I really liked it. And next, about the power. Yes, Bajaj has increased the horsepower on this motorcycle from the previous generation one, but I'm more concerned about the torque, because in touring, it's not about high speeds, it's about the torque, because you're carrying load and you need to overtake other trucks and cars, and you need to move ahead. And when that needs to be done, you need to have torque on tap. So you'll see some video clips now where I was able to overtake effortlessly, sometimes even without downshifting. So, more than enough torque you have on this motorcycle. And now the most important question, kitna deta hai mileage? So, I'm giving you rough figures, all right, but very sure about what I'm speaking, almost sure. That is, I'm getting about 23 kilometers a liter okay? You can definitely get way more, but we were riding very slow, because when you ride slow, actually the fuel consumption is higher, okay? Because you're riding in lower gears, okay, and sometimes in higher RPM. So even after that, we were getting about, I mean, I was getting about 23 kilometers a liter, and that is really, really good. If you're on a highway in the top gear cruising at about 120 or 100 kilometers an hour, I'm sure you might even get 30 kilometers a liter. So really, really good fuel efficiency. And this is something absolutely critical. You know, there are other high compression, good powered engines, motorcycles, which have a huge issue, that is overheating when you're riding slow. And yesterday in those mountains, you have already seen these clips that we were sometimes riding only about 10 or 15 or 20 kilometers an hour for about 2 hours. So that time, technically, you know what happens, right? Air can't really get onto the radiator as a blast. So the cooling system, the radiator fan, and the whole cooling system has to work well on its own. And there was no heating problem whatsoever. So it did well. I mean, there was a situation where I was riding all alone for about 1.5 hours in some proper jungle. And if anything would have happened to this motorcycle yesterday, I know my team would have come back and got me, but I would have been in bad shape. So I was practically trusting my life on this motorcycle. But nothing in life is a complete proper package. So one thing, if I have to complain, that would be the brakes. There are other people who said this, but I'll explain this to you technically. All right. When people say brakes are bad, brake is not just one component. Okay. There is a master cylinder. All right. Okay. And okay, there's a master cylinder which produces the hydraulic pressure, and there will be a brake hose through which the pressure, the high pressure hydraulic fluid would go in. That this is the brake hose, and this is called the caliper. Okay, all the pressurized hydraulic fluid would go in and press pistons against something called a brake pad, and that brake pad will touch the brake rotor and produce friction, and that is how your motorcycle would slow down. All right, everything is good. The hydraulic pressure is being produced by the master cylinder. The pistons are working fine. The rotor is good. It's a huge rotor, but the only concern is the brake pads. These are regular, ordinary brake pads. All that you have to do is take them off and buy double HH grade brake pads or sintered brake pads, and you are sorted. Right now, what is happening? It is too progressive. The brakes, if I start applying, there is no bite. Okay, it's slowing down, but there's no bite. And sometimes some people like bite, some people don't like bite. I like bite in my brakes. So if you are a person like me, I would say don't worry, it'll hardly cost you about 1500 rupees or so, or 2000 rupees or so, to buy double edge pads. Take them off, put them on, and the brakes would improve by about 50 to 70%. I've done this to all my other motorcycles too.
Buddies, I forgot to mention this point when I was reviewing the motorcycle, but this is extremely critical. I spoke about this in the previous version of the Dominar, and I was not very happy about it. That is, now we all know that the Dominar is an amazing motorcycle for touring, correct? But when you're touring, you need critical information about the motorcycle right in front of your eyes. I mean, you don't have to, you should not be looking down onto the tank. Or in this case, like, what is happening is that the Dominar, this beautiful motorcycle, has all the critical information like the gear shift, like the odo, and the clock. That screen, the rectangle screen, is on the tank. Okay, so when you're touring, 99% times you're going to put a tank back. So when you put a tank back, I can't see that information. And even if you don't put a tank back, I would have to get my head all the way down and look at it. It's not good. So when I was touring, I couldn't see the odo. You know how important it is to see the odo? You might see a milestone where it says 50 kilometers and that I have to take a right or something like that. How will you know? You know, in case you don't have a GPS display, how will you know that 50 kilometers is done? You have to look at the odo. Next, gear shift. Personally, to me, the gear shift doesn't matter so much. But for someone who's learning to ride initially, it's really important for them to see which gear they are in. And then the clock, the time. I was using my cell phone to check the time. So This is something which I spoke about in my review of the 2017 Dominar also. I was thinking Bajaj would do something about it. I mean, they can have this display on the tank as a secondary display, but critical information like the odo and the clock, it has to be there on the primary speedometer.
And buddies, you know this, that although Bajaj is a big sponsor for this whole Odyssey, but you know that no matter who is sponsoring what, I will say what I believe in, okay, regarding whichever brand. So that is what I've done right now, okay, right? And I would also like to mention that XBHP team is going through many countries, many different weather conditions, many different riding conditions, and the oil that we had to actually fill into the engine had to be very, very, very good, because we were not sure that, you know, would we be able to change oil in 5,000 interval, kilometer interval, or 7,000 kilometer interval. So our major partner Castrol is something which we thought is a very, very good bet on using the engine oil, and well, we were not wrong. Amazing, amazing performance in cold conditions, like in Bhutan early morning it was freezing. And you know how to check if the engine oil is good or not? The Castrol engine oil that we're using is 10W50. I made a video about what these numbers mean, okay? The 10 actually means it can take very cold conditions. If the oil would have been 20W40 or something like that, early morning, if the temperature is about 4 or 5 degrees Celsius, you see this glass here, if you move the motorcycle, the oil will be very thick. So it is not good for cold starts, okay? Your engine, the oil will not circulate well in the engine, and your engine in the long term can take a beating, okay? And 50, the number 50, you know what it means? If you're riding in very hot conditions, okay? The engine oil viscosity should not become too thin. So this Castrol oil that we're using can take very low temperatures without becoming too thick, and can take very high temperatures without becoming too thin. So very good. And also, it's a fully synthetic oil. I mean, I'm not saying this officially, but I'm saying this with my experience. This oil can actually take up to 15,000 kilometers of riding or driving, with my experience I'm telling this. If that is in case your oil filter supports. I'll talk about this in a technical video. And as I always said, that doesn't matter which motorcycle you have, which engine you have, if you don't have good tires, what are you doing? You'll not be able to ride well. So our partners MRF, excellent tires. You know, in Bhutan, in cold weather conditions, we can have black ice. Black ice is the moisture, the water on the road can actually freeze, and we'll not know. And if your tires are bad, you'll be in bad shape. And we were riding in sand, we were riding in off-road conditions, and we were also riding in very wet conditions. And these tires are something which I've handled all of it. I really like the compound. If you see, I'm pressing this with my nail. This is not too hard. If it would have been too hard, then the traction will suffer. If it's too soft, then we'll not be able to ride for thousands of kilometers. It'll wear out. But perfect compound, and the sidewalls are strong enough to take bad potholes. And the tires are actually so good that we haven't needed to top up air for thousands of kilometers now, and many, many, many days. So well done, MRF, on this. And of course, you all know this bike has ABS, and it really helped in bad weather conditions and slipper clutch. When I'm on the highway, when I'm in a good mood, or when I'm on the twisties, slipper clutch, hard downshift, no problem, the rear is not going to lock. Worked really well. And that's it from my side, buddies. Thank you very much for watching. And in case I missed any points, let me know. I will speak about them in detail, because I have gained a lot of experience riding this motorcycle now. And if you're not subscribed, do think about it. If you like this video, do give it a thumbs up. And that's it. I'm there on Instagram, Facebook, and I'm not there on TikTok. Bye-bye.